5-year-old Clydesdale gelding moose, who's in for training, and today we're doing episode 3 of our Groundwork for Success series. And today we're going to do backing up, and our backing up exercise kind of has a few different components. So the first component is steady pressure backing up. So that's where you take the pressure on the nose band of their halter and you ask them to back up off the halter pressure. And then we're going to do a couple rhythmic pressure exercises where they have to back up off that kind of give and release type pressure. So the first thing I want to mention is the difference between steady pressure and rhythmic pressure. We'll probably make a quick tip video kind of going a little bit more in depth with steady pressure versus rhythmic, but steady pressure is any time where the pressure is placed on the horse and it's left there until the horse does whatever you're asking them to do. So for example, if it's backing up, either pulling on your lead towards their chest to back them up, or anytime you have your hand on the horse, whether it's on their nose, their shoulder, their hip, and you're pushing them in a particular direction, that's steady pressure. You're keeping that pressure pushing on them until they give to it, whether it's backing up, yielding their hip, shoulder, what have you. Rhythmic pressure is any kind of body language or like stick and string pressure where you're just kind of rhythmically flicking it, or when you're kind of tap, 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 tap with your stick and string or with the end of your lead rope, your hand, that's all rhythmic pressure. So for our backing up exercise, the rhythmic pressure is going to be kind of shaking the lead a little bit and getting them to back up to the end of the lead. So our very first task when introducing the backup is to get them soft off the steady pressure. So I don't even necessarily need my stick for that exercise, but you're just gonna take your lead, you're gonna kind of bring it towards the horse's chest, and you're just gonna back up. On his face, but we can refine that as we go. The rhythmic pressure, if I bring him back up here, is where I take the lead rope and I just kind of shake it a little bit, and the amount I'm shaking the lead rope is going to determine on whether he's responding or not. So he's not doing anything, so I'm going to start shaking it a little bit more and a little bit more until he kind of takes a step back, and then I release all of that. And that's the rhythmic pressure backing up. For one of our exercises, the other rhythmic backing up is when I just kind of step into the horse and I kind of have a level of expectation there that they're going to move out of my way. And that's where the stick comes in handy. Because I'm just going to take my lead so it's not dragging on the ground. I'm just going to start stepping towards him. If he's not backing up out of my space, I'm just going to tap his chest with my stick and get him out of my space. And then as he gets to know those cues, just step him up off that pressure, as he gets to know those cues, I should be able to just step up into him and he'll back up. Didn't even have to raise my stick. And always make sure when you do have to get after them and bump their chest, you just kind of rub that away a little bit. Stack them out again to your stick and string, because you want them to be light on your cues, but you don't want them to be scared of your tools. It's no different if you use the end of your lead rope to kind of pop them a little bit if you don't have a stick and string. So this exercise is basically just another form of body control. You want them to be able to back up under saddle. So obviously getting them to back up and use their body on the ground is the first step. If you ever need to back out of a trailer, or stuff like that, you need them to be able to back up. And obviously when it comes to leg yields and some more, lateral work, them knowing how to carry themselves backwards is not necessarily a bad idea. That's how you get some of your fancier backups where they can back up a serpentine, a circle. Sometimes if you're a competitive person in trail class or cowboy challenge or working equitation, you have to back up an L, or sometimes you have to back up a circle. Like, them knowing how to back up is a very good thing. And it also kind of keeps that bubble of space around you to where they don't get pushy. And it also just gets them softer through their body and builds some good muscle on their hind end, and that's never a bad thing when you're training horses. So, steady pressure. Steady pressure, just using the lead rope and backing them up. But ultimately, I don't want to use too much steady pressure. Whenever I back up a horse, I'm always sure to kind of bring them back forward, draw them back up off that pressure, because sometimes if you have to use a lot of pressure to get them to back up, once they back up, they kind of lock themselves there, they don't want to step forward again. So you always want to kind of draw them back a little bit to get them soft through the whole process. So this is the very first step to an exercise we do a little bit later on that we call the step up and step back. And that's where we take the rhythmic pressure, usually the shaking of the lead, and get them to back up all the way to the end of the line. So until I'm holding the very end of this rope, I want him to keep backing up. Once he backs up there, I will stop the cue and let him take a moment to kind of sit there and relax. And then the step up part is obviously drawing them back towards you with as light of a feel on their head as possible. So that is kind of the end stage of the backing up exercises. At the beginning of our program, at the end of the program, we do like backing up in serpentines and circles and like your different yielding the hip and shoulder during the backup. But I'm going to try that rhythmic pressure, and you can always use your stick to kind of pop the air a little bit as needed, as you're shaking if he's not quite responding. And don't hold on to the lead rope so tight that he can't back up, because you got to be able to let this feed through your hand a little bit in order to get him to the end of the line. So I'm going to start shaking, wait for him to respond, pop the air a little bit because he's not quite responding. You guys can see, this is only a 10-foot line, so it's a little shorter. But he's now back there, and I want him to wait until I give him that cue to step forward. So once he does, wait, I'm just going to slowly kind of draw this line back up towards me, and look how nice he leads up. If I want one more step there. I'm just going to hold that steady pressure coming towards my chest. There we go. And then once he gets up here, make sure to love up on him a bunch, because he didn't even do that too shabby. Some of these backing up exercises. new. So you've got your stick and string exercises as your first thing. And you've got your yielding the shoulder, yielding the hip as the second task that we do in our groundwork program. And that third task being this episode, which is the backing up. So stay tuned for episode 4, which is going to get into more of the movement exercises, which is going to be our sending exercise. And we'll probably end up back with a different horse for that, just to show some variety in the horses we have in our program. Some of them are at different stages, so it's kind of nice to show you more of that introduction to the exercise rather than, like, Moose, who for the sending exercise is already relatively refined, so I want to show you with a slightly greener horse with that exercise so that you guys can kind of see how the introduction of the cues all fit in together. But in order to have the most success for your sending exercise, your horse has to be able to yield their hip. They have to be able to yield their shoulder, and ideally you've done a little bit of that step up, step back, so that they know how to step up off that halter pressure, and then they